Hello everyone, hello and good evening. I hope you're all really well. I am going to just double check that everything is working. And it looks like it is, so that's good news. Oh, let me turn my noise down. There we are. I think we're up and running. Excellent, so I can see us on Facebook, so that's a great start. And we'll just check that we're also live on YouTube. And then we're all good to go, aren't we? Yeah, that's all working. Hello. Hello, Jess. Welcome. Hello, Claire. How are you? Hello everyone. Oh, hi Angie. I'm so glad you could join me. Let me get rid of this and I'll go to Facebook because Facebook is a bit easier to follow. Oh, hello everyone. Jess says she's so happy to be crafting with us today. Oh, that's amazing. What are you crafting? What are you up to? Tell us what it is that is on your crafty table today. I would love to know. Okay, let me have a think. I've got a couple of ideas of what I wanted to do today, but I mean that may all go out of the window when I start thinking. Actually, yeah, I haven't used this die yet, have I? So I had a couple of ideas. Sorry about the glare there on these particular dies. I haven't used the new home die yet, which I thought might look quite cool on the front of here with some little critters in the windows, a bit like looking into a house. And then there's also the You Had Me at Meow, which I've not used. But I'm quite liking this idea. Using the window die. So this is the stitch window cover die. I can never remember the names that I call things. And the new home, because I've not used this yet. So I thought it'd be quite a good idea to use something I've not used before. So I'll just crack this open and say hello to a few more people as they join us. So Laura's here. She says, hi, Jo, how are you doing? Zamara's here. Laura Ann's here. Hello, hello. So I'm doing okay, is what I'm going to say. So I'm really sorry that I've not been around. I don't seem to have done a live for so long. I've not felt very crafty, truth be told. And for obvious reasons, and we've had lots to kind of deal with, stuff to focus on, and it's been tough. So so one of the reasons that I wanted to make sure I came on today was because this is going to be the last live crafting before we go on our holidays. So we're not going to see you again for a little while. So I wanted to make sure that I came on and said hello, even though I'm still not feeling totally with it from a crafty point of view. But I thought it'd be really good just to do something that was a little bit just a little bit creative, a little bit me, take a bit of time out from the day-to-day stuff that I've been doing, and have a chat with you guys and say, hello, and that I really appreciate you all, and I appreciate all the love, best wishes, cards, gifts, messages, they've all been so lovely, and we've so appreciated them. We can't thank you enough. So it's been horrendous, and I'm not going to talk about it because I will cry. So I'm just going to crack on, and we're going to make a card, and I'm going to power through, and see what I can come up with. Angie says totally understandable. Lauren says using the large die for a card for a few weeks, but not sure what else I'm doing on it yet. Just I blended a background to cut the die from. Very nice. That sounds cool. Laura Rumble says yes, totally understandable, and huge hugs. Jess says making card backings for some pin badges that you've made, but I'll be moving on to lots of different crafty bits today. Oh, you've got lots planned. That's good. And she says it's glad to have me back. And Dawn says lovely to see me. Thank you. And the reason you're not seeing my face is one, I feel that the pure overhead seems to stream better. So fingers crossed, we don't have any issues. So I didn't want to mess with that because that seemed to be working. But also, I look like I've not slept for quite a number of days. So I'm looking forward to our holiday and get a little bit of sunshine on my face. A bit of rest and recuperation is definitely required. So that's where we're at. And we'll talk as we go along, but I don't want to forget to tell you things because I'm terrible for forgetting things. The shop will remain open while we're away, but obviously we won't be able to ship anything, so we will hang on to your orders until we get back, and then we'll be able to ship them out to you. So either place your orders and be patient, or wait until we get back. It's entirely up to you. We are going, Laura, we're off to Gran Canaria. Nicola says, hi Joe, big hugs and hello. Hello Nicola, thank you for joining us. Class, is it? I'm not sure where you're from. I'm assuming you're saying hello. So hello and welcome. So we're off to Gran Canaria. This holiday has been booked for a very, very, very long time. We booked it back in 2019, I want to say, because it was when it was before COVID happened, and then COVID happened and our holiday did not. So we are now in the position where, hurrah, we can go on holiday. It's been a long time coming. It's been one of those holidays that we never thought would ever arrive. it's funny. So you can see I'm just having a little bit of a mess about here. I'm having a little play around with some elements from the this is me forgetting what things are called again. Where is my lovely home set? Here she is. It is the home is where the heart is, of course. Set. And I'm thinking that I'm going to create like a little bit of a house scene in the background here, which could work quite well. So just create this little bit of a home scene, perhaps. This is very cute, isn't it? We could use some of the critters from other sets. I'm just seeing which ones I've already got, because you can see here that I've got loads of bits that I've already die cut and coloured. So we could use some of these items to make a cute little scene here, is my thoughts, because I think that would look really quite sweet, wouldn't it? The idea of having the TV at the table with the phone on there as well, so we could kind of tuck that behind there with a little plant. That's kind of cute, isn't it? That is kind of sweet. I do quite like that. And then we've got another little plant that could sit down there, and then the sentiment at the bottom. I think that's quite sweet. I'm going to colour this up in probably different ways, because they don't really match the colour scheme that I had in mind. And the colour scheme that I had in mind, I've had a look on Pinterest for a colour scheme. So I keep a little board with different colour schemes on here that I might want to use in a card design. And actually this theme here, apart from the pink, actually could work, couldn't it? Because we've got kind of a red tone there. We've got a nice orange. I don't know if I can blow that one up. Let me have a look. There we go. So this is kind of a deep orange. So that's, you know, we can substitute that for red easily, I think. We've got a nicer orange, which we've got there. We've got yellow, we've got green, and we've got blue. So I've used all of those colours elsewhere. My little kitty, I think I'm going to make a ginger kitty because that would go. And then if I remove my little, the pink lampshade and the pink phone from that setup and colour them in a different colour, then I think we could make this pretty cool. So I'm thinking blue lampshade, maybe a red phone. Yes, that could work, couldn't it? So I've not really figured out what my background's going to be yet and what this is going to be. This could end up being quite colourful, so we might want to keep the background a bit more neutral looking. And also the new home, again, I want to think about what colour I want to do that in and this border. So, but I'm quite liking this setup. And we've also got the sentiments welcome to your, which we can include with the new home. And I'm sure I've got them in here somewhere amongst all of these pre-die cut bits. I've got the to your look. So there's welcome to your new home somewhere. Got where the heart is. Let's have a look. I do love having, you know, things already die cut and already stamped, because it does really help when you come to do, you know, wanting to do a card a little bit quicker. And, you know, I'm making some adjustments, but you don't really need to. The only one I can't find is the welcome. It's typical, isn't it? I'm sure it's in here somewhere. It's because I'm just trying to find it quickly, and obviously I'm not going to be able to do that. But we can always stamp it again. I love having all of these sentiments already. So is oh, there we go, welcome, yay, welcome to your new home. Yeah, and it doesn't have to be the cat that's on there. I mean, we've got the little red panda, we've got all kind, I mean, we've got any number of critters, haven't we, really? But we've got all different I'm just pulling out the new stamp sets that we've got. And the different cats that are on there and different critters are on there, just for ease of use. But also we've got the movie set with these little guys who could sit on the sofa as well with a drink or the popcorn or the chocolate. So, you know, that could work as well, couldn't it? And then there's also the Hey There Critters. And I think the little mouse sat in the middle could also be very, very cute, couldn't he? So, yeah, that could be very sweet. So, right, let's have a little tidy up, and then let's cut some bits out and see where that takes us, shall we? This is very much a making it up as we go along, so we'll see. Laura says, oh, we should get some nice sunshine. I do hope so. And Dawn says it's just what we need. Angie says a holiday will be good for us. Absolutely. Hello, Alison. How are you? Oh, thank you, everyone. Yeah, I think this would look quite cute, won't it? So we've just got to come up with what my kind of background is going to look like, and we've got a few bits, extra bits that we need to stamp out. So let me have a think. Just have a little drinky poo. And thinking about what my main colour should be as my outline. Do I have the blue? Do I have the red? Do I keep it kind of neutral with a white? Decisions. Because it is pretty much going to be the colour for the rest of the card, isn't it? So this is some pale blue, which is probably not the right shade of blue. I want a bit of a darker, brighter blue, but I can ink blend that maybe onto this blue, and then if that's the outline, or should that be my background? Might make that my background. I'm thinking, let's try, or should I do the yellow? The yellow might be nice as the background. So these are kind of my elements. Look quite good against the blue, don't they? Or we've got a bit of kind of this, where is it? Nice pale kind of a, almost vanilla kind of a shade in the background. So this is just going to change the look of all of those colours completely. So it's made them much warmer, hasn't it? So that's warmed them up quite a bit. And then the pop of colour over the top, does it want to be white? Does it want to be blue? And I think the way to kind of test this for me is going to be, wood grain would be nice, wouldn't it? So I think we could do like a craft colour, couldn't we? That would be quite nice. Should we try that? Should we try a bit of craft card? Have I got some craft card here? What's this? Let's see what this looks like, because it doesn't, you know, it doesn't really matter, does it? I'm just going to cut this down. Yes, for the frame, Laura, I like that idea. So we're going to cut this down, and I can add a little bit of a texture to this with some ink blending. And I could use the wood grain stamp on this as well. If you've got the wood grain stamp, that's a really cool stamp to do something like this. But I'm just doing this quite quickly. So this. Noise. Oh no, it moved. How did it move? Heavens, that's annoying. Oh, but it worked. So my die did move for some reason, even though I used washi tape on it. It did move slightly, but thankfully it didn't move beyond the outside edge, just managed to cut it. So that's good. We would have to do that again. So we've now got our kind of wooden frame here. So this is nice. I quite like this vibe that we've got going on. We could do a bit of ink blending here. So that's looking nice. I'm liking this with the nice kind of vanilla-y kind of yellow in the background. And then we're going to get the new home just sitting on there, which would be nice. And again, the new home, we can do, I think maybe it that would be nice to do in this kind of, this fresh blue, bit of a pop of blue might be nice. So let's have a look at a card base for this one. Pop that bit of paper away, tidying up as we go. I don't know why it doesn't want to go back in its little house there. It's got caught on something. So I need an A6 card base because this is an A6 size panel. So that's going to fit beautifully on there. And I need to cut my cardstock down a little bit so that we can fit this onto the front of our card. So this is the A6 layers die set, and I'm going to use the largest of my dies here so that I can get a really nice clean cut. So I'll just pop a bit of tape on there, and then I am going to cut this down. I think I'm going to need some more of this, this cardstock because I'm almost out. I think that might be my last piece. I've got smaller pieces, but I've not got a full size piece. So make sure this doesn't move around this time. So what's everybody else up to this evening? Are we doing anything Jubilee related? Anybody having any Jubilee themed parties or events near them? We're not doing anything kind of ourselves, but if we get chance we might go into our local village that's having a few different events on Saturday. There's a few things going on locally, just general types of businesses doing kind of Jubilee themed things. There's stuff going on in the park, and like I say, that around the kind of marketplace, and so it's going to be very, very festive. I feel so this is going to be my background, and then this is going to be on top. So I'm thinking then the contrast colour is either going to be green or blue. So we've got this, because we've got these nice little pops of blue and green along with those oranges. So it might be nice to do maybe new and home in different colours. Lauren says she's doing a video game night with friends just because everyone is off work tomorrow, but we'll still be watching and reading the captions and comments. Oh, bless you. Video game night. What is this? I need to know what this is. Angie says she's just having a medicinal Bailey's, got an awful cough and kept you awake for two nights. Oh no, Angie, that's awful. A medicinal Bailey's sounds like just the job. Just the job indeed. So let's have a think here. Think with my brain, which is not the most functioning part of me at the moment, but we're persisting. So I want to ink blend this a little bit. I think, I mean, I quite like it the way it is, but you know what I'm thinking? Might be nice to do a bit of a tiled wall background for this. I mean, I do like it quite plain though, and I don't want to ruin it by adding too much fuss. So, because you know, fuss isn't always a good thing. So let's, and I'm thinking, you know, let's keep it a little bit simple because we've got a lot of things going on here. And what I'm thinking with my sentiment, because I don't have the right coloured cardstock and I want to match the colours that are in the rest of my my colour scheme, I'm going to try, I've not tried this for a while, so I don't know if this will work, but I'm going to try and colour them with my Copics. So I've got a bit of super smooth, actually that's quite thin super smooth, and I've got some thicker pieces in here, that's quite a nice thick piece. Is that big enough though? Oh, plenty. So what I'm thinking is that I do New Home in blue and then the rest in green. So the colours that I will have used is now, I've got to try and remember, so that's going to be fun. I've got a BO2 in my BG file, that's no good, is it? So let's have a look, see what colour this is. So friends live down south, so we use video chat to do a game night with board games or quiz games. What a great idea. Stacey, hello, first time I've caught you live. Woohoo! Oh, I'm so glad you could be here. So we're just doing a bit of an experiment at the moment. My BO2 seems a little dry. I'm going to use the chisel end here just to get a bit of colour on here. But yeah, my BO2 seems a little on the dry side. So I'm going to have to go in the replacement pile. And let's try some BO4, which is much more juicy. So I reckon that's probably enough to cover. So just try and blend those out with my super dry pen. And I'll use the BO1, which is much healthier, just to blend those together a bit better. That's better. Bit of a saturation on that paper. That'll help a little bit. So it might look a little bit messy at the moment, but it will blend through. There we go. That should work much better. So let that dry. But yeah, definitely need to replace this now. So yeah, I'm getting a little collection together of pens that need bit of upgrading. So because I've put quite a lot of colour on there, I'm hoping that's going to dry back nice. And then we are going to go for some green. So I've used quite a nice fresh green here. So I think rather than the RGs, I think I've probably used green, a more greeny green, if that makes sense. So let's have a look. I feel like this, it says it's quite that's not quite green enough. That's a really nice colour of green, isn't it? Or it could be this kind of, that's definitely more that kind of green, isn't it? This is where you can't remember which green you've actually used. That looks more like the kinds of green. What's the GO5 look like? I think that's probably more the colour that we're going for. So let's try this. So Dawn says that she's going to be running a tombola on Sunday at a food and craft market to raise funds for the cat rescue charity that you're a trustee of. Should be fun with bunting in abundance on all the stalls. Oh, that's so good, Dawn, and what a great thing to be doing. I hope you raise tons and tons of money for the cats. Stacey says, I'm crafting with my Pentel fiber tip pens. You can watercolor with them too. Just got them tonight. Oh, there's nothing better than getting new pens, no matter what kind of pen they are, whether they are Copic markers, whether they are watercolor pens. We're just getting those new pens out and playing with them. Oh, it's just the best thing. So have fun and enjoy, Stacey, because I love playing with new pens and old pens and just all the pens. But yeah, that is a fun night right there, Stacey. So what are you going to be making with these pens once you've played with them? Do you have a project in mind, or are you just having a general play? So these colours, technically speaking, aren't really next to each other on the Copic chart. So probably shouldn't work, but I think that they do. So, and you know, like I always say to you, don't overthink it, just do it. Which is actually what Maverick says in the new Top Gun. Has anybody seen the new Top Gun? It's very good, but I liked the old Top Gun, so I guess I'm a bit biased. So you can see I've not quite done enough there for my home, so I'm gonna have to come a little bit further out here so that we can get all of that on there. So let's just blend those edges through. Bit of GO6. And Ant is absolutely obsessed with the soundtrack. So Ant is of an age, which pains me to say, that he wasn't actually born when the original Top Gun was released. I know, it's annoying. So he only watched the original Top Gun last week, the week before, before we saw the latest one. So he had no idea about it. He had no idea of the soundtrack and how great it was. So he's now obsessed. So I feel like that may be oversaturated now. My blue is blending back really nicely. But I feel like I'm going to wait and see if this dries a little bit better. It doesn't look too bad on screen. In real life, it looks a little bit patchy. So I'll just show you the close look. But that's because I've gone over it a few times. So like I say, this is a bit of an experiment. If this doesn't work, then my next plan, which I'm going to do as a comparison, because we're having a little bit of an experiment. I feel like I need a little bit of a thicker piece of cardstock. But maybe not. Maybe we'll just use these pieces because these are big enough, aren't they? So I'm just going to pop that to one side. Stacey says she's working on a 6x4 canvas, just a small one, and doing an underwater scene. Oh, that sounds awesome. Very, very creative. Love that. And Angie says she needs to do some colouring soon. People have found out I have a sewing machine here, so you've been doing a bit of that. So you've been the one roped into doing all of the sewing. Hi, Jane, how are you? And Alison says, sorry, I missed it if you said about the pens. Are they regular Copics? Yes, these are the Copic chows. These are the round ones, and these are the Copic sketch ones. And I have a mixture of both, and I use both. The chow are a little bit cheaper, and that's why I started with them. And then when I was using them a lot, because they were starting to run out a bit quicker, I then went to the sketch ones because there's a bit more ink in those. So what I do have here is some Catherine Pooler inks, and these are really good to just swipe. Where's me mat? Get my mat out here just to protect my surface, because what I'm going to do is, and this might be a bit of a deep blue, but I'm going to try it anyway. So I'm going to do a swipe of blue. See, that's quite a deep blue, but it's very pretty. And then, so that might be a bit dark. Let me have a look. Is there a different blue in this collection that I've got? I don't have many of these inks. So this is more of an aqua colour. Let me try that. Just make sure that my... So this is a bit more aqua. So this one, again, might be too aqua. Oh, yeah, that's very aqua. Pretty aqua, so that's not quite the right colour either. But when these dry back, they look absolutely beautiful. The ink pads are so cute. We've used that one. Let's try this Lime Ricky, because this is a really nice colour of green. Try not to get it all over my fingers. Oh. Very, very juicy pads, as you can see, but they will dry back. So I think that's a great colour green. I'm definitely bought into the green. So the green's going to work, I think, when that dries back. But I think the blue might be a little bit too blue, because this is the blue that we're using. But it will pop. It will pop. So we just need these to... So I think these look better and smoother than my Copic efforts. So I'm gonna cast them to one side. I think we're gonna use these. I'm just gonna let this one dry back a little bit, and then let's see what these look like. And this is the aqua one. The aqua one seems to have gone a bit more patchy, so I might have needed to do another coat of that one. But again, it's still a really lovely colour. So yeah, let's pop these away. And then I can start. That's a nice bit of cards. There's a couple of nice bits of cardstock actually that I can use to stamp my images. I could even use the back of that if we're not using it, but I won't do. I'll save that because I need to do another lamp, and I need to do another little telephone, and I need to do another cat, don't I? So let's put them to one side so that they just dry a bit further. I'll do some stamping of move things around in my craft room, and now I can't remember where I put everything. I keep putting it back in its old place and not its new home. So let's grab this, and then, like I say, we just need to stamp these three images. And I think that this is a piece of stamping card. It feels fairly nice, but I might just exchange it for another slightly more confirmed piece. Used this for something previously, I'm not sure what. Let's just trim off some of these gnarled edges so I can get it lined up a little bit better. There we go. And I need the lamp. Hello Cam, how are you? So I love this lamp. I love this little home scene. I think it's very cute. In fact, I could do another little plant in a deeper blue, couldn't I guess, so that it matched. But I quite like the light blue, it just it adds a little pop, doesn't it? So that's them two. And then I needed a little critter, and I was gonna do a ginger cat to go with the orange theme. So I thought that went quite well, in that there's not many other orange critters, are there, that I know of anyway. So let's try this. This is going to be my challenge, is my cardstock moving around, because it's not exactly straight. So we'll just use a bit of tape to hold that in place. Bit of my Memento Tuxedo Black onto here. And then press this down. I should also as well apologise for the state of my nails. Normally I have very nice manicured and painted nails for our sessions, don't I? But unfortunately, I am in pre-holiday beautification mode, if that is a word, where I'm going to be doing my own nails, which I tend to do, my own kind of acrylic and gel nails. So I'm going to be doing my own. So I wanted to give them a little bit of a rest from, you know, the gels and everything before I did that. Because they never really have any time off. I've always got some sort of gel polish on there, or it might be just normal nail polish on there. Might have extensions on. So I thought it might be worth them having a little bit of a rest from all of that for a little while before I do them ready for the holiday, just to make them feel a little bit stronger, because they are very weak, not very looking very healthy from all of the abuse that they've had. So these are my in a bit of a state, au naturel nail, so don't look too closely. Right, so, colour scheme. Now, what have I done with my little book of colouring? So, I have a little book of colouring with little examples of how I like to colour the cat. So, we've got the little calico cat. We've got the tabby cat that was coloured just like little Rosie, which is very sweet. But I also have ginger kitties coloured up in here as well. I think I've just got the one, actually. Yeah, so there's this little ginger kitty, which is really very simple to do. So I'm going to colour her ginger. And then I think we said blue, was it blue lamp? Just imagining how it's going to go. I think blue phone. It's going to go like this, isn't it? You see, so this is going to go as such. So yeah, blue there, and then we said red phone and blue lamp, didn't we? Claire says, am I taking any craft on holiday? I probably won't take any actual craft products, but what I will probably do is take my sketchbook with me, because that's what I like to do when I'm on holiday, is because I find it quite hot. Too hot to craft a lot of the time, and we tend to be the type of holiday makers, Ant and I, who don't really like to do much other than just lay in the sun, to be honest. Maybe drink a cocktail or two, maybe listen to a podcast, read a book, read a magazine. I'm taking a lot of my, I've built up a bit of a stash, shall we say, of crime magazines. I don't know if you'll have seen it here in the UK. It's called Crime, I think it's Crime Monthly or something. So yeah, I've got a couple of Crime Monthly magazines. I've got a couple of crime. Oh, wrong colour. Sorry there. That's, and I'm not showing you my colours, which is naughty of me, isn't it? Yeah, sorry, what was I saying? Yes, so I've got a couple of kind of crime novels, so not true stories, but novels to take with me as well. And then a couple of just your usual trashy magazines, you know, you kind of your Heat and that kind of thing, which we do enjoy. Aunt pretends he doesn't, but he always reads them. So the red that I used, I'm trying to remember what shades of red did I use. 34s, 35s, what am I saying? Or the, yeah, that looks like the colour that we used. So but obviously the brain never really fully switches off from work and crafting, so it's very likely that I will get inspired by something while we're there, and I want to draw it, I want to sketch it. So that's what I will I'll do. I will take a sketch pad with me, and then I can just anything that you know, that I feel inspired by, I can just capture it in the moment, and then I'm not trying to remember it when I get home. So that's probably the only kind of crafting that I'll do while we're there. The rest of the time we will be absolutely just relaxing. And one of the things that I'd never really get a chance to do at home here is just read, and I love to read, and I've always, you know, read books and things as a kid, but since adulting, I've not done so much of it. I'm going to grab some of my sea shades of grey. So I've got a C3, C5, and let's try a C1. And I'm going to add a bit of grey to this stand. So a bit of chrome in there, even though everything else has been wooden. I feel like this would be a chrome stand. And then for the rest of the foam, I'm going to use, now I can't at all remember what shade of yellow I used, but they were very warm shades of yellow, I feel. So let me try, we'll try the Y21. Just along the edges of this foam, and then in the centre there, and then the Y15, we'll just brighten that up a little bit. There we go. And then my thoughts are that I would do a bit of the grey again, just around the keypad, dial. I can't even think what we would have called it. So just tiny bits of grey on there, nothing too wild. And then with this darker yellow, the Y15, add some little dots of yellow to those numbers. There you go. Just put them all back in. Cute. Right, okay, so next to my colour of my kitty, and I haven't zoomed in, so I hope that you guys can see. Shall we zoom in for the kitty? Let me zoom in a little bit so you guys can see a little bit better what I'm doing. So we've got Y21, which is one we've just used. We've got YR20, which is this one. YR14, YR27, and 24. There we go. So a nice little array of colours. And then I've used E93 for the pink bits. So where's my E93 gone? That's E95, E93. There we go. So I imagine what I will have done here then. So let's start with the Y21 and a bit of a yellowy base, if you like. And I'm bringing that down from the ears, around the little, the bottoms of the ears. There's some tufts in his ears or her ears. This could be a little ginger tom, I think, because we do have a ginger tom that lives next door to us, and he's very, very cute, and he keeps coming round and crying for attention, and we think that he is crying for Rosie because they used to play together, which is very, very sweet. So yeah, he's cute. He's not fluffy though like this cat. He's not a fluffy ginger cat. He's a short-haired moggy. So we've got a base layer of the yellow on there, and then the YR20 is going to make this a little bit more muted and a bit more orangey. So it's just going to soften that yellow down a little bit. So I'm going to go over everything that we've just done and just over the edges so there's a bit more of this colour popping through. So again, like I say, it's just toning down this yellow, but we do need a little undertone of yellow because that's going to help us with the kind of the orangey effect. Next up, I'm going to use the YR14. And this is where we're going to start getting a little bit of the, I guess, the stripy tigerness of the cat coming through. So again, just a few little brushes of this, but you're not covering as much of the background as that you did before. So I'm going from the outside in and flicking. So this is where he's going to become really quite ginger. So flicking towards the center, and then again round the little feet there. So we're leaving bits of that undertone just showing through. From the tail, I like to do kind of a center point and then flick out from that center. So you're kind of creating that stripe from the middle. That makes sense. And then you can go back over this with your YR20 to soften those edges out a little bit if you want. So just blend the little lines around the ears, blend some of those tufts into the middle a little bit so they don't look quite so harsh. Blend those all together. Blend those ends around the tail. So that's just created a little bit of a smoother look. And then with the YR24, we're going to create actual stripes. So a bit of depth around the ears as well. But then we're going to do a stripe, bold stripe, bit of a thicker stroke now, just to create those bolder stripes. Stripes down the side as well, a few little flicks there on the feet, stripes up there, and then again we're going to do stripes from the center of that tail, like so. Make that bit down at the bottom a little bit darker as well. So I hope you can see a little bit what I'm doing, because my hand covers it up a little bit. The YR27 is then going to go down the center of those larger stripes, so not as wide, just down the center of them, and again that's just giving you that little bit more of the tiger stripe coming through, and just defines them that little bit more. I'm just going to reinforce that center line, reinforce those stripes, and I think that is just adding a bit of this darker color underneath the areas where there would be a little bit of shadow. So we still are going to get a bit of shadow, so don't forget the shadow and the shading. And that's pretty much the gingeriness done. And then the E93, just to give a little bit of pink to the ears, pink to the cheeks, and a pink nose. And I think that might need a little bit of deepening. So I think that the, let me think, the YR20 may be a bit too pink. What's this RO2? Yeah, the RO2 is a good pink. It's a bit more kind of salmony colour than in your face pink. So, and our little friend next door has got a little pink nose, so that works. Yeah, that's a little cat done. So let me try and organise my pens now, because I've got them everywhere. So what are your favourite characters to colour in? What's your go-to when it comes to colouring in characters? What do you always like to colour? Do you like to colour cats, dogs? Do you like to colour other kinds of animals? And if you have a favourite kind of go-to critter, do you colour them the same sort of shades every time, or do you like to mix it up? So I'm just cutting down my cardstock, because I'm going to use my smaller die cutting machine here. So I'm just lining this up, and I'm going to make sure that I stick down this centre piece, because I don't want that to move around. And then I've got my little telephone. Lovely. And then I need my kitty cat die as well. Oh, I think my little cat is very cute, styled on little Rosie. So I'm so glad that I've got this stamp set already produced, because I can then colour in little Rosie images to my heart's content, can't I? get my die plates and pop this through, and then we're almost ready to start putting this together. So cute little mice, says Nicola. I'm obsessed with crafting anything that's mice related. I am planning some mice stance. So like I say, when I take my my sketchbook with me on holiday, I am, although it's going to be very summery vibes, I'm hoping to channel a few autumnal vibes while I'm there. And I'm thinking mice are definitely going to be a feature. Angie says that she has to mix the colours of the cats up when colouring, as we have a few different flavours. Yeah, you've got lots to choose from out there, don't you? Which is really cool. And Stacey says, when she uses her tribe lens, I don't know how far to colour before I start to shade. Right, okay. I tend to use the colours that I've chosen to build the shade in. So the darkest colour of the tribe lens would be my shading colour. And I get my base colour down first, then I add the shade, typically. Laura says, birds are my favourite and I love to colour leaves and flowers. See, I've never really been one for doing flowers. Florals have never been my thing. But, you know, I do see some absolutely beautiful designs using flowers. And I have drawn flowers in the past. So, who knows? Never say never. Nicola says, yay, can't wait, yes please, to the mice. Where did that come from? There we go. Just make sure I'm matching up all of my dyes where they live so I don't lose any. I'll pop that away and I'll zoom you back out so that you can see what's going on the rest of my very messy craft desk. So let's zoom. Oh, that's probably enough. All right, we'll go back in one. There we go. And maybe one more. There we go. too wide, you can't see enough. Too close, you can't see it. You can't see anything. So, the next thing... Oh, I put my dye machine away. But actually, this will fit on here because I'm going to cut it all in blue because I've done enough blue colour. So, we'll cut it all in blue. But then we can choose which bit we want to use, can't we? So line this up on here and die cut this. And then Annalisa says, hello, all lovely to see you live, Joe. Hello, Annalisa. Yes, it's good to be here. Good to be chatting to all of you crafty crew. Oh, that looks so good. Oh, and you know what? We could just... come out H. We could just make the heart a different colour. That would be cute, wouldn't it? So they've all decided to come off together like that, which is quite handy. I wonder if I can pick them up with my tape. What did I do with my tape? Is it here? Yes, there it is. Why don't we? Just gonna rub it on my hand to take some of the stickiness off because I don't want it to rip my cardstock. But I do want it to pick everything up. So just taking a bit of the sticky off will hopefully protect my cardstock a little bit. So picks all of that up in one go. Picks all of that up in one go. So let's try the green. A lovely green as well, so let's see which one we prefer when it comes to it. And I'm tempted to cut this out a couple of layers of extra cardstock as well, for a bit of extra dimension. We do have can layer this up. It has got an outline die as well, but I'm not going to. The H keeps getting stuck in there, doesn't it? So I've got a bit of white cardstock here. Let's just cut this out as well, and then we can do a little bit of a layering situation. So I've got another scrap piece, and then we'll have three layers, and that should make a nice, decent. decent sized of dimensional sentiment. So new home and one more. I've got some bits of scrappy pieces. We could use the back of this one, couldn't we? I think this is slightly different cardstock, which is why this one might not come out as well. I don't think this was our super smooth, but it has dried back better than it looked, to be fair. So again, we've got new home all cut out. So I've got a few of these now to layer together, but I don't know which ones I want to layer together yet. Come out of there. There we go. So that's my new them out of the way so that we can see what we're doing, because we need to put our little actually I might stick these together because we know these are definitely going together, aren't they? The two white ones, and then I'll not lose them. So I'm going to get a bit of my glue on here, and we're going to glue a couple of these hearts as well. I do love doing this. I know it's a little bit time consuming, but it's so worth it. Hello Emma, how are you? Stacy says, what do you mean put the base colour down first? Do you not just colour in with the colour you're using? I don't want to get what you mean. So if I'm using three different colours to make up my design, my base colour, the first colour that I put down, I colour the entire image in the lightest of those colours. So say I'm colouring in, so like when I did this, the lampshade here, for example, for the pole, that's all I can think of calling it, I put the palest grey all the way along, up covered everything. That's my base colour, if you like. And then I added the mid-tone colour at the top and the bottom, and then either side of the little cone at the base of the image. That is kind of the secondary colour for the item that I'm colouring in. Then the third colour is the darker tone, and that's the one that I've used to shade. So I've added that at the top and at the very bottom and the very outer corners, and then blended those all together. So when I'm saying base colour, what I mean is the first colour that I'm laying down and covering my entire image with is my base colour. And that for me, I find that's the easiest way to get a good blend. Because I'm saturating my paper with that lighter tone first, and then I add my colour on the top of that. I know that probably didn't make a lot of sense. I'm sorry, Stacey, if I didn't explain that very well. It's easier probably when I'm demonstrating to see what I mean. And if this is the first video of mine that you've watched, there are loads of other videos where I do show how I build up the colour and add the shade in for an image. So for another example, the sofa, I will have put this lighter colour that you see in the background, I'll coloured the whole thing in that first, and that will be my base colour, and then I'll have built up the mid-tone and the dark tones into those shadowy areas to give it a bit of depth, I guess is what I was trying very, very poorly to say. So we've now got new home in a bit with a bit of dimension there. Dawn says she loves the font on the sentiment dies. Oh, thank you. I like this one. This one is a lot of fun. So, and do you know what? Sentiments are one of my favourite things, but also the bane of my life, because I could spend more time looking and altering fonts to suit, you know, the project that I'm working on and the stamp set that I'm working on, than I do creating the actual stamp set sometimes. Bertie says, hello from Denmark. It looks very nice. Oh, thank you. And Stacey says, yes, she's got two. I have got you now. That's for that, as I have been starting with the darkest colour. So it is better to use the lightest colour first. Subscribe to your channel, watch many of your videos. Oh, Stacey, thank you. That's really cool. Yeah, so a lot of people do suggest starting with the darkest first. And I think there's a... Not speaking about anybody in particular, but I think there are some people who are a little bit like, oh, when you're really good at it, you will start with the darkest first. I think that's nonsense. I think you do what's more comfortable for you. And for me, I think getting your paper prepped by putting that pale tone down first is just going to make your life easier. And it's all meant to be fun and enjoyment. You're not meant to be having to work for it. You know, this is our hobby. This is our love and our pastime. Let's not get stressed, is my point of view. Sorry, I've been talking a lot and I needed to have a little slurp of my drink. Okay, so let's pop this background on first. And I'm going to use some liquid glue to pop this down, because this will just help me with a little bit of wiggle time for when I don't put it on straight, which, you know, I am partial to not doing correctly. And one thing that I do like to do, and I don't do it enough, is using my stamping platform here to help me line up my base, because it just helps you get it into the corners, and it just makes that so much simpler, because you can use the corner of the stamping platform to help you do that. And I just feel that does work so much better for me. And I might do the same with this. My only issue with this is that I do want to pop this table a little bit behind it, so I might do that first. So I've got my table and I've got my little cactus, and I'm also gonna have my little telephone on there, aren't I? I'm gonna layer those up. So what I think I will do to make my life a little easier is I'm gonna add these onto the table first. So I'm gonna add little bit of glue on the bottom of there to add my telephone, and then a bit more glue onto this guy here, because I'm going to add him in the front. I don't know why I make all of my images, I give them all the is it a pronoun I'm giving them? I'm making them male or female either way, aren't I? I'm making them male or female for some reason. So what I want to do is pop this on the table, and the table will fill most of that square, but it's going to hang over the bottom. So my thoughts are, I line that up just there, and then we add a bit of glue just there. And then line this back up over the top where that would sit, and then I can trim off those little feet you see? Yeah, I think that works. So now I can just get my scissors in and just trim off those feet. And then we won't see that bit. And then the TV, is that gonna sit? I think that's probably gonna sit on actually in that area. The chair over the top, so that's sound. So I don't think anything else really needs to like tuck under. That would look nice tucked underneath, I think, possibly. So yeah, I might do that. Might add a little bit of glue to the very, very bottom of there. So just tuck that underneath, but with the edge of it hanging over the corner there. That's nice. And I like the, you know, the different kind of dimensions then that that's going to give us. Some are going to be a little bit set further back, some are going to be popped up with foam tape. So these ones though are all going to lay flat on our background. So a bit of glue over everything. Again, using this as a way of helping us line this up. I can pop this lined right up against that edge. There we go. And that should work nicely. So I'll take this out because I know this is giving a little bit of a glare. I'm just going to grab a couple of nice sturdy acrylic blocks that I've got here just to give that a little bit of a press down and hopefully get that to stick in place. Dawn says that's a great tip for lining up. Yay! Stacey, you're from Scotland. Whereabouts in the world have we got then everyone else? I know we've got Claire and Jess are from Lincoln. Where else is Annalisa in Canada? Angie, you're in Greece. We've got a real worldwide audience today. I love this. I absolutely love this. So I think that might be enough pressure for our little background here. Laura's in Sussex. Yes, Skiathos in Greece. Yay. Oh, I've still got so much packing to do as well, which is rather filling me with a bit of anxiety. So straight after this, I will be going and doing some sorting of clothes and packing. You know what it is, I think, so Ant's never normally really bothered about spending too much time packing. He just, you know, chucks in what he's got and away we go. But he's lost quite a bit of weight recently. He's been on a fitness and training program and he's lost quite a bit of weight. So it means that none of the clothes that he wore last summer fit him anymore. So we've had to buy him a whole new wardrobe, so he's been, you know, proper taking his outfit coordination seriously. And so he's actually, you know, probably spent more time organising his clothes than I have. Excuse me. And but for guys, he's got to work out what shoes, what shirt, what trousers, and he's pretty much done. We have to think about what underwear we're gonna need to wear with it. What jewellery we're going to wear, what handbag. It's a whole thing. So I need to sort all of that out. Dawn's in Newcastle and Julie's in Manchester. Yay! Emma's from Swindon, but you're in Scotland at the moment. So you're near where Stacey is then, maybe. Well, just because you're in Scotland doesn't mean that you're near where Stacey is. But and Alison says, when are we going away? So we go away... next a week today. Oh, week today. So there will be no live next Thursday. There will be no live on Tuesday either, because we are literally moments away from going away and we've got so much to do before we do. So yeah, there will be no lives after today until we get back on the 21st, which I think I want to say is a Tuesday, but I can't remember. So our first live will be the Thursday after that, I guess. So yes, but the shop will still be open. If you want to purchase anything, it's just that we won't be shipping it. There's no one here to ship it for us, I'm afraid. So yes, so you'll have to be patient and we'll ship it when we get back. Alison's in Essex, and Angie says she'd love that problem. All your stuff is too small. I know that I'm the same, Angie. I'm not happy with this. Annalisa says you always pack at the last minute and you're not fancy at all, you just bring shorts and t-shirts. So yeah, that, I mean, shorts and t-shirts for day is good, but if we want to go out for a meal in the evening, we like to get a little bit dressed up, and it's that bit that causes all of the stress and drama. And also gets a bit like, why do I need a bikini for every day of the week? Well, why not? why not? Simply that. So we've got new with the green. I think the green at the bottom is going to look better still. New home. Because it's not exactly the same colour green, but it is cute. And then that gives us new in blue, which again is not exactly the same blue, but actually it doesn't look as dark as it did when we first stamped it, does it? So we've now got new home, and I want it to overlap that frame ever so slightly. So new home. New home just there, and I was thinking that we might do the blue heart there, but would it be fun to make that red, because we could colour that in. Don't think there is a red, there's kind of an orange. Not a red. So I can colour. I'm going to colour this in and see what it looks like. Because that would look quite good. Or we could make it an orange. Let's pull out some more of that orange. But let's try the red first of all. I'm just going to pull that up. So Stacey, just to show you that I put that first colour down, the lighter colour first, and then I'm just pulling in the darker colour from around the outside, and then I'm going to just blend that together into the middle. Just make that a little bit darker. I can't quite remember for the life of me which third colour I would have used with this combination. I don't know if I need it. So I think that just finishes it off, doesn't it, to match the couch. So, and what we can do with this is we can also, I've got ink all over my fingers, is just colour these edges in so that they are also red, which I think is going to look quite cute. So I can layer these together with the red. Or do some, I don't think you're going to be able to see that, are you? So I'm going to lay those together. I might do them upside down. Yeah, that works better. So we've still got that same dimension. So let's layer these together with my inky fingers. And then we've got all of our sentiments layered up. And then we can add all of our other little images as well. Sorry, I should come back into the center so you can see what I am doing. And then add that onto there as well. And get that adhered. There for a second, and I will fill that in. So for these areas, I'm going to pop this guy down flat. I mean, there might be the majority of these things might be flat, but I think that just there is going to look pretty good. And then I'm going to pop the cat flat onto the couch, just there, which is very cute. And then I might pop him up on some foam. So I've got my foam here. Come on, it's got tangled up together. Oh, how is that? How on earth have I done that? Got them tangled up. So got my my wide foam tape, which I love. I'm going to add a bit of this to the back of the couch, like so. Oh, I cut that a bit too long. Oh, no, just bang on. So then that will go there. And I think we'll add a bit of dimension to the TV also. So I'll chop a bit of that off as well. Going to use the darker red for this. Love the red heart, says Laura, and Dawn says perfect. So I'm just going to colour in these edges. Not that you'll really see them, but just to get rid of any thoughts that they were a different colour . I love layering these up because it just does mean that you've created your own little chipboard element, which is cool. And I'm just not lining that up perfectly, but that's fine. So I need to add the dimension to these guys, don't I? So let's just move this up here and the H. So to say that this was a completely no planned, no idea what I was going to do, not feeling at all crafty or, not feeling inspired at the start, I am really pleased with how this is turning out. I think this is really sweet, really fun card to send to someone who is moving into a new home or has moved into a new home already. I think especially if they've got a little ginger kitty, it is perfect. So we're not doing the green new, are we? We're doing the blue. So and you could obviously, the colour scheme that I've used is one that I've just plucked out of thin air. So you could make the colour scheme based on the recipient's actual home, an actual cat, or you could use one of the dogs from the Doggone Mutts stamp set. You could use a mouse or any of the other critters if you wanted to, if they don't have pets, then you could just make the critter maybe the recipients themselves, which would be quite cute. And you don't even have to have a critter on the sofa at all, could it? Annalisa says she's off to vote. It's election day in Ontario. Looks beautiful, Joe. Oh, thank you. You should, good luck with that. You should, you know, it's important that you vote. And I know you've got lots of things going on in your country at the moment, haven't you, Annalisa? So, happy voting, if that's a thing. Annalisa says, you and Aunt are such a beautiful, handsome couple. I don't blame you both for dressing up to the nines. Oh, that's very cute. I don't feel very beautiful, I have to say, at the moment. But Aunt is very handsome, I agree. Angie says it's been good therapy for me. It has, you know. Dawn says it's fabulous. Nicholas says, I think I need that frame dye. I love it. This, I think the frame dye has got so many possibilities. You know, you're creating like mini scenes within each bit, aren't you? And I think it's just really nice how it compartmentalizes your story a little bit. So you don't have to think about filling the whole thing. You could just fill a little bit of it. And I think that's quite a fun thing to do. So let me just figure out where. I think I might put my sentiment in first so that my cat doesn't overwhelm it, and I can use this centerpiece as my guide to make sure I line this up fairly central. Let me use my tweezers here to just pop this in place. And the fun thing about the font that we've used here as well, I think, is that it doesn't matter if it's not straight, because it is a bit of a wonky kind of font. So sometimes it's a little bit, it's fun to just have it a little bit on the wonk, or bits of it on the wonk. Obviously that is kind of my default sticking position, is on the wonk, as you know. So a font that helps me disguise that and make it look like it's intentionally wonky is all good for me. So, and I'm going to start with the H here. I'm just do work the outside in. And because my W is a little bit larger than the N, I might well have moved that over, but I didn't like the fact that my E wouldn't have been central if I did that. So it's kind of, which is your preference? Do you want that to be central or the E to be central? So the whole word to be central or the E? Swings and roundabouts, as my granddad would have said. So let's get in, and then we're almost done, I think. Considering that I've not done crafting for a little while, this is not too bad. In terms of, you know, time that it's taken me to do this. It's good that we had some images already coloured, because I think it would have taken much longer had I not already got those coloured. It's come together quite nicely, hasn't it? Come together quite quickly. I love the colours that we've chosen as well. I do think that they're really quite bright and funky. They've got a little bit of a retro feel to them because of the go with the retro telly. There's a bit of a rainbow vibe without it being an actual rainbow. So yeah, I'm digging it, as they say. So again, we can centralize down the middle there, the cat on the sofa. And then the final little bits, I just need to add some white jelly roll to it, the bits that we've just colored, because I've got those on the colors, the images that we colored previously, but I need to just make them match really with everything else. So a few little highlights here and there, some little whisker marks for the kitty, a few little dashes on his fur there, just to give the impression of a few little bits of highlight, maybe on the ears as well. It's quite cute. And then on the I think on the sentiment itself, adding a few little bits of white jelly roll just helps bring that up, doesn't it? Yeah, I like that. And I don't really have any rhyme or reason where I like to put these bits. Just, you know, have a play. It doesn't really matter. There are no highlight police, so just do what you feel looks good. And I think that is probably job done. I don't know if you can see that actually on screen. I'm going to bring that a little bit closer so that you can see all of the detail that we've got onto our sentiment and the highlights on the kitty and everything. I think that's turned out pretty good. I'm happy with that. I think that would look good. Now, we didn't put the extra sentiments on that I spent ages looking for, the welcome to your, but you know what, I don't think it needs it. You could still add it if you wanted to, you know, you could add those in there, but I really don't think it needs it. I think just the new home sentiment on its own just works really well, and then obviously you can stamp that sentiment on the inside. Alison says, fantastic card, Jo. Laura says, such a lovely card. Yeah, it's fun, isn't it? Yeah, I'm pleased with that. So thank you so much for joining me for the my first live for a while. Nicholas says, beautiful. Thank you, Jo. Hope you and Anne have a great holiday. You deserve it. Night, night, all. Thank you. That's such a lovely thing to say. And, you know, we are both so very, very grateful for all of your support and all of your kind wishes during what has been probably the most harrowing 6 months of both of our lives. It's been tough, but Time for Tea has absolutely kept us going through all of it. And all of you guys have what kept us getting up every day and having something to look forward to. So thank you so much. Dawn says, love it. Thank you so much for your time. You're so welcome. And Angie says, love it. Enjoy your much needed holiday. We absolutely will. And we're hoping that, you know, we will find some little cat friends while we're out there that we can feed, because, you know, we do always tend to do when we're out there. We will, obviously, the design team will still be around and we'll be able to answer any questions that you might have, and we'll be sharing their inspiration with you while I'm away. And I will see you all back here towards the end of June with some more crafty fun. Thanks so much, guys. Thank you ever so much. And I shall see you all really soon. Bye, guys. Thank you. Bye. Thank you, Emma. Thank you, Alison. Thank you, Laura, Dawn, Stacey, everyone. Thank you so much. Bye.